might be.
Without further ado, Alice Bag reading and the Alice Bag band playing. Let's give the bigger team a welcome.
So, I grew up, I got into junior high school, and I started picking my own songs. Because, you know, when you're a kid, you're at home, your parents pick your music, your older siblings pick your music. And then you get into junior high, and you're like, I know what I like. So, I started listening to David Bowie and Elton John, and I listened to Bowie first, and I thought, oh, he's really cool, I like him, but then, you know, he was openly bisexual, so I thought, I can't really get too focused on him, because I thought I was going to be a groupie, you know, and I thought, oh, I latched on to Elton John because I thought he was straight. and I became an obsessed fan. And let me just read you a little bit about learning to get into my own music, since we're in a music store. Listening to rock music and talking about how it felt like I was discovering my way home. I made new friends who were all rock fans. But not just ordinary rock fans. They understood the appeal of rock artists who were pushing against convention. It was one thing to like Led Zeppelin and quite another to like David Bowie and Elton John, who were seen as total freaks by most of the kids at my school. There was a lot of homophobia in the early 1970s. Elton John was closeted at the time, but he wore outrageous outfits that raised speculation about his sexuality. I was convinced that Elton was straight and that someday I'd meet and marry him. Bowie was openly bisexual, a relatively new concept to teenage kids in East LA, and one that was very threatening to a culture that preferred clearly defined gender roles. Around the same time, the movie Lady Sings the Blues came out. I was already a Supremes fan, so I enjoyed the movie without the burden of having to compare Diana Ross to Billie Holiday, since I'd never heard of Billie Holiday before. I bought the soundtrack, and through that, I became interested in finding original music by Billie and Bessie Smith. I fell in love with both of them and the way that the two very different, yet very powerful women expressed themselves through their music. I was in the process of redefining myself. The tough girl look and attitude had helped me, but I didn't fit into gang culture. My class clown antics had negatively affected my grades, and my love of rock music had not won me general popularity, but it had gained me a few quirky friends who appreciated my offbeat taste. There had always been a soundtrack to my life, and I had always loved music, but up until this point, it had been selected for me by others. My father, sister, teachers, peers, my surroundings had dictated the soundtrack to my childhood. Now there was a new sound in my life, a self-guided audio adventure. My world was becoming stereophonic. I imagined myself in a musical where people sang to each other instead of speaking and spontaneously broke out into dance numbers. My heroes were artists who defied society with their music, their outrageous clothes, and unconventional sexuality. Suddenly, everything was gloriously colorful and open to endless possibilities. Everything good in this music, appropriately called glitter, spilled over into the way I looked at my life and myself. I'm going to do an Elton John song for you that we sort of simplified and punkified a little bit.
But it's still kind of fast.
Okay.